Hi, I'm Jaya. I work at Cohesity, and today I'm going to talk about strict consistency and how critical it is for your storage system to be strictly consistent. At Cohesity, we provide you with a strictly consistent storage system, and it is really important for you to consider this aspect of the storage system while choosing it to avoid problems like data loss, loss of performance, not meeting backup SLAs, and wasted resources. To begin with, let us try to understand what exactly is strict consistency. Imagine you are writing to your storage device, and this storage device is divided up into data segments. And this particular data segment has the value A in it. And now you want to update this value to the value A prime. In a strictly consistent storage system, now if you were to read this data segment, you will get the value A prime. But in an eventually consistent storage system, for some time you may still get the value A, and only eventually, if there was no update in between, you will get the value A prime. Most of the traditional storage systems are strictly consistent, and most of the applications, even the applications for backups and restore, they expect the underlying storage system to be strictly consistent. Then where did the question of eventual consistency even arise? It all started in the early 2000s, when the likes of Google and Amazon made scale-out systems popular. Now, these scale-out systems are quickly replacing the traditional monolithic storage systems, and these scale-out systems consist of multiple hosts. And they are typically built out of commodity hardware. And with commodity hardware, failure is considered a norm. So multiple copies of each data segment are maintained. For example, data segment A may have a copy on host 1 and host 2. Data segment B may have a copy on host 1 and say host 3. And data segment C may have a copy on host 2 and host 3 and so on. Now, a decision that a storage system has to make is how to handle the updates to the replicas of the same data segment and how to handle the reads for the data segment. In a strictly consistent storage system, there is always an overlap between the subset of replicas that are updated as part of the write and the subset of replicas that are consulted on a read. That is how a strictly consistent system can always ensure that a read returns the value returned by the most recent write. But in an eventually consistent system, what may happen is you may just update, say, this replica to A prime and say, I'm done with the write, and then eventually in the background sync the two replicas. So for some time, if you were to read the data segment and you are reading it from host 2, you may still get the value A until the values are synced, and then eventually you will get the value A prime. But what happens even before you are able to sync, there was a permanent failure on host 1 and you have lost your data, you have lost your update here, and that is the problem with eventually consistent storage system. That is why you want to go with a strictly consistent storage system. Now, let us consider two examples with backups and restores to understand why it is important for your backups and restores to work with a strictly consistent storage system. Let us consider an example where Oracle database is being backed up using Oracle RMEN to the secondary storage. Now, this is Cohesity's strictly consistent storage system, and this is some other vendor's eventually consistent storage system. What happens as part of the backup? Data is read from the primary and it is written to the secondary storage. Now, while the backup job is running, if there was a permanent failure in the secondary storage, suppose this node was to fail, and similarly, suppose this node was to fail in the eventually consistent storage system. What happens with Cohesity? Your Oracle RMEN application continues to run as if nothing happened. The backup continues from where it was, even if a node were to permanently fail. But what will happen in an eventually consistent storage system is that if the only copy of the data was on the node that failed before it was synced with the other replicas, you have to essentially restart your backup from the very beginning. And what are the disadvantages of that? You may miss out on your backup SLAs. You are wasting resources. You are again reading the entire data and writing it to the secondary. And last but not the least, the users running of the primary are impacted because the data is being read again from the primary, all the data. And users may see lower performance from the primary. If this example was not enough to convince you, let me give you another example. And this time we'll talk about restores. Let us consider an example where a user is doing an instant restore of his virtual machine from the secondary storage. Now, what happens behind the scene when user is doing an instant restore? In order to provide instant restore, what happens until the data is entirely copied from the secondary storage to the primary? All the user writes are absorbed on the secondary storage. So, if a node were to permanently fail while this is happening, what happens on coherently strictly consistent storage system? User's data is still safe because there is yet another copy of the data on some other host. But within eventually consistent storage system, user has lost his data because if the only copy of the data was on the node which failed and it wasn't yet synced to other host, user has lost his data. So the next time you are choosing your storage system, do remember to ask your storage vendor, is their storage system strictly consistent like Cohesity's or not? Thank you for watching.